Good morning to all my children. I hope you all are fine. From today, we are going to start with the first chapter of geography, that is resources and development. So let us begin with the chapter. Since ages, man has exploited the nature to fulfill his needs. With the help of technical knowledge and his skills, man has used the nature. But his overutilization of the natural resources has created a lot of problems. Before we come to this chapter in detail, first of all, you should be very clear with the term resource. Well, in simple terms, resource means anything that satisfies our need. Water, soil, animals, these are all resources. But at the same time, a resource should also fill certain conditions. It should be technologically accessible, economically feasible, and culturally accepted. Now, what does it mean? Take an example of gold. Gold is a resource, but we can use it only when we have the technology to extract it and change it from its raw form to pure form. Then it should be economically feasible. It means that the economic output for the resource should be more than its economic input so that there is no loss. After using technology to extract gold, we should be able to make enough money from this gold, which is higher than the money which we spent in extracting the gold, so that there is profit. And ultimately, a resource should be accepted by the society. Now, how do we transform things in our environment to get a resource? Well, there is an interdependent relationship between nature, technology, and institutions. Human beings interact with physical environment and find out things which can be used by us. For example, we explore forest and use wood. We take out minerals from deep inside the earth. And this we do by using various technologies and ultimately create institutions. For example, if we are extracting minerals, we create mining industry. If we are using forest product, we create fuel wood industry. All this together create a resource. Now let us study about types of resources. We have natural and man-made resources. Natural resources can be further classified into two types, renewable and non-renewable. Renewable resources can be physical and biological. Further, biological resources can be natural vegetation and wildlife. On the other hand side, non-renewable resources, it includes recyclable things, example metal, and non-recyclable things, example fossil fuels. Then human resources, it includes structures and institutions. And second, the quality and quantity of human resource. Students, now we would study about the classification of resources in detail. We would study about classification of resources on the basis of origin, exhaustibility, ownership, and ultimately on the basis of status of development. Today, we would cover classification of resources on the basis of origin and exhaustibility. On the basis of origin, resources can be biotic and abiotic. Biotic resources, they are obtained from biosphere and they have life. Example, human beings, flora, fauna, livestock, etc. On the other hand side, we have abiotic resources. They are composed of non-living things,
example rocks and metals. Beta, you can very well see in the picture the biotic and abiotic resources around us, consisting of living things and non-living things. Students, next we have classification of resources on the basis of exhaustibility. As you can see, it includes renewable resources and non-renewable resources. Now, what are renewable resources? Renewable resources are replenishable resources which can be renewed or reproduced by physical, chemical or mechanical process. Solar energy, wind energy, water, forest, wildlife, they all can be reproduced. On the other hand side, non-renewable resources, they are formed over substantially long geological time. They take many years for their formation. Example, minerals and fossil fuels. They can be further subdivided into two parts: recyclable resources like metals and non-recyclable resources like fossil fuels, which cannot be recycled and get exhausted with their use. So students, this is all for today. Now at the last, I would like to give you some questions as assignment. Please go through these questions and write down their answers. If you are not able to understand it, watch the video once again and you will definitely